biegam.
Cześć.
Voting and the winner is...
And the winner is... Snake. Which...
Robimy tak naprawdę takiego trona w rzeczywistości. Czy też...
Snake'a w rzeczywistości.
Właśnie.
Że biega się z telefonu komórkowym w ręce.
I zbieramy informacje na temat lokalizacji obu graczy. I działa to w taki sposób, że wygrywa osoba, która albo okrąży drugiego gracza w rzeczywistości faktycznie, bo dokładamy na bieżąco lokalizację poszczególnych graczy na mapę, albo w sytuacji, kiedy jeden z graczy wpadnie na ścieżkę budowaną przez ruch drugiego gracza. Nie wiem, na ile to intuicyjnie brzmi.
Jakiej technologii?
Serwer jest pisany w Pythonie, aplikacja kliencka jest robiona póki co na iPhone'a, a jeżeli idzie o web, to używamy PHP, jQuery, JavaScript.
PHP nie używamy, dzięki Bogu. Chwilowo. Dopóki jeszcze nie symulować wyników.
Tak, właśnie.
Jak długo już pracujecie?
Dzisiaj od 9?
9, 10 godzin.
Na jakim jesteście etapie?
Mamy praktycznie gotowy serwer.
Znaczy serwer ma jakieś problemy życiowe, właśnie kupujemy je.
Tak, właśnie, ale to już jest, to są bug fixy, a nie robienie tego de facto bazy. Jeżeli idzie o player, no to jest akurat podgląd tylko z Google Maps, plus nakładamy, to są teoretycznie dwóch graczy, to są boty aktualnie.
Zrobiłem serwer.
No, więc...
Już bot żyje i serwer żyje. A może nie.
Docelowo te bloki będą rysowały się jeden obok drugiego.
I między tymi blokami będą takie, które będą łączyć te połączenia. Na razie mamy kłopot z tym, że nie działa interpolacja między blokami, czyli nie ma ładnych ścieżki między blokami, tylko jest jeden blok, drugi blok, dwa
bloki. Tak, ale docelowo będą rysowały się linie de facto z bloków i w momencie albo okrążenia przeciwnika, albo wjechania mniej lub bardziej chcący w linię przeciwnika.
Tak jest.
Chcemy zrobić test z ludźmi, którzy będą biegać, będą jeździli z iPhone'ami na rowerach. Najprawdopodobniej uda nam się jeszcze załatwić dwóch motocyklistów, którzy będą próbowali jeździć z iPhone'ami. Jest jeszcze trochę czasu, jest noc. Najprawdopodobniej uda nam się jutro pokazać naprawdę działające demo i wyglądające.
Ogólnie tutaj widać przebieg bota. Na początku ma jakieś, coś tutaj kręci dookoła i potem robi taką ścieżkę. Tak naprawdę bloki będą mniejsze i będą jeszcze pomiędzy mniejsze, które będą łączyć to. Czyli tak naprawdę nie tak. Będzie to tak, nie będą to kropki, tylko będzie to naprawdę piękna linia.
Dobra. Z dokładnością plus minus 20 metrów.
Plus minus 20, nie, 10 metrów bloki.
No tak,
dookoła. Ale to jest wszystko do zmiany.
So hello everybody, we're Team 33 and we're here to tell you about our idea and the progress during the weekend. So we are called CG Race with me, and let me remind you and tell for the first time for the judges what the idea was originally in Friday. The idea was, judges, have you seen the movie Tron? Or played a snake, you know, snake game on Nokia phone? So the idea is, I have an iPhone and you have an iPhone, and we're like 500 meters away from each other, and I play, do you want to play? And you accept, and we both see the map of streets of Warsaw, and two snakes on it, you know? You control one snake, I control the other snake, you know, but the crazy twist is like, there is no swiping, touching to control the snakes, we run on the streets. And this is crazy, we run, we drive bikes, or cars, and we wanted to make it happen. And let me tell you about the progress, because we promised to deliver in 54 hours, you know, and we have done it, you know. By now, we have iPhone app prototype, working app that you can see there, you know. We have iPhone app design, the target design, that we need some more tweaking to. But we have the application server really working. This technology works right now. And we have web viewer, you know? So you don't just take our word that, you know, two people are running there and, you know, they are having fun. You will be able to see it on the web, you know? And we also spent plenty of time with mentors working on business models and PR, and it is in your folders. We'll talk more about it now. So the business. Is there a business in it? We don't think so, because this has the wow factor to it, and the game that I told you about, this is just the first game. We are going to do plenty more games when we test the technology, you know? Because there are many frameworks for city games, urban games, but there is no framework for dynamic games, you know? You will see the snake in the real time, you know? This will happen, and it's going to be amazing, I think. So, we have, do we have a business model? Yes, more than one. This is covered in inner folders. Thanks to mentors, we have prepared scenarios, you know, brief scenarios, only 54 hours, for how to monetize it, for the size of the market, and how can we actually sell it. And now, very important part, the team. You know, I'm just a humble game designer with like 4 or 5 years of experience and project manager, you know, but I gathered like great people are in this team, and shout outs to them now, because this happened only because of them, you know, like Tomek Kolinko, who was designer, he helped with UX, and please applause for every person, you know. Thank you, Wojciech Kolinowski, who made the iPhone app happen, you know, and all the coding from the iPhone that was working. Grzegorz, who was doing everything, designing, doing JavaScript, helping with server, doing this presentation, you know, great stuff working, and Sergiusz, you know, who programmed the server, Jarek, who did the finance and market, and Agnieszka. So, 7 amazing people, and okay, I think time is over, but you have the flyers saying, play the band again, we made just one... And we made just one, sorry for technical problems, we made just one short movie to show you how we see this whole fun field.
I love it.
It's 20 seconds.
I'll allow it.
Do you want audio?
Yes.
You can sign up for Visa, you know, and most importantly of all, you know, what, can I speak like 10 more seconds?
No.
Okay, so just, okay.
See you guys, not me!
That's us, we're there.
Thank you very much.
Any questions?
Yeah, I'm fascinated by the police aspect of this thing. what sort of a revenue cut do you... What sort of a revenue cut do you get on the speeding tickets people are going to be paying?
We can't disclose the details on this business deal, but we're working with them very close.
I think there's an assumed NDA here. So, the second side of the story is, what about liability of all the people who are going to be breaking legs and other elements while they're playing this and looking at, you know, driving and running?
The way we think about it, we are creating like technology for a new category of sports, you know, and sure, you can break a leg while playing basketball or riding a mountain bike, but that's up to you to take care of your safety. We provide the technology, some of the game rules, you know, the motivation to do healthy exercise and stuff, but it's up to you to take care of your safety. We'll provide the guidelines, but it's up to the player.
Okay, thank you very much. 10:23.